guys, it's Ms. Welcome to my YouTube channel. Sorry I haven't uploaded a video in a while. I have had a crazy couple of weeks. In my last video, I probably mentioned that I've been house hunting. Well, in the last week that really came to fruition, I found a home that I really liked and I'll be moving in about a month. That took up a big chunk of time and was very, very exciting. Also, my cat Garfunkel is sick. He has the coronavirus and is being treated for that. But that was obviously pretty stressful for me. He's on an antiviral treatment. If you have any experience with the Devon Rex or a kitten with the coronavirus, I would love to hear it because the stuff I found on the internet wasn't super encouraging. He's okay now. He's eating and playing and isn't showing any symptoms besides having really swollen lymph nodes on his neck. They're pretty big. So hopefully that'll start improving soon. So you can tell from the title of this video that this is all about my weekend at the John Waters Sleepaway Camp. I have never been to camp, and when I heard about this event 6 months ago, I thought it looked like fun and that I could get a couple people to sign up. Well, I went on the day that they offered registration and it was sold out, so I added my name to a waiting list. Well, the early part of last week, I got a call and they had the room type available that I wanted and I got the ticket. I hung up the phone and immediately was struck with so much panic.
Oh my God, what have I done? What am I thinking?
Going to a sleepaway camp in the middle of nowhere, Connecticut, with, you know, 300 people that
I've never met before.
I just decided to go with it. I liked the idea of meeting other John Waters fans. I think that anyone who is a big enough fan to trek all the way to this event must be pretty cool. But I was really, really anxious. Well, 2 days before the event, I was telling another friend about my plans, and she said, do you think that they'll have another ticket? And I said, I don't know, but you can call and ask.
Well, she called, she asked.
And they had a cancellation on the other line. So they called her right back and she booked the ticket and had even less time to prepare than I did. And we ended up meeting up at the airport and then driving to the event. So Camp Getaway is a really traditional camp geared towards adults. They have traditional camp experiences like making s'mores and water sports on the lake and crafts and movies, but with a boozy adult slant. It was an amazing place to host this event. Ultimately, I think around 340 people attended. 300 of those people were in cabins, and I think the other 40 were camping. I might be a little off on the numbers. We didn't take a census. Somewhere in there. We didn't get the itinerary for the event until right before we went, so I really didn't have a lot of time to think about what was gonna happen or what the activities were. I will say this, Camp Getaway has perfected the art of getting people comfortable really quickly and organizing events that people will participate in. Everything that they had planned for the weekend was amazing. John Waters movies were constantly playing on an outdoor screen. There were themed dance parties. The 2 nights we were there, every morning there was a colorful and fun brunch. It was just perfect. I have to say that I have social anxiety. I'm naturally kind of a nervous person, and socially, I've had some difficulties because I am a sex worker and a pornographer in fitting in. Sometimes I can attend an event or meet someone new and be judged, and other times I become the focus of conversation in a fetishized and uncomfortable way where I feel like I'm under the microscope. Going into the event, I wasn't sure if I would talk much about myself. I didn't know if it would be a highly social environment or if there would be a lot of opportunity or what I would say. And I was a little nervous about it. I want to be liked and I want to be honest about who I am at the same time. But that anxiety was totally not even needed. This was the nicest group of people I have ever been around. Every single one of those people was incredibly friendly and sweet and open and wanted to get to know me and wanted to tell me about them and connect over our love of filthy cinema. I found that a lot of people that were there were very sex worker aware. A lot of people said they had a friend or a relative that was a sex worker at one point. They were also very kink friendly. It was just really, really great. All of my nervousness was out the window. And I made a ton of new friends. When my friend and I put everything in our cabin and got dressed and went to the meet and greet cocktail party, which kind of started the event. Everyone came to the main tent and had drinks and got to know each other. Every group that we walked by waved and said hello and asked where we were from. People were outrageously friendly. They were also outrageously creative. Everyone had on a colorful outfit or a John Waters themed something or other. It was just beautiful. I really loved it socially. I really loved it visually. It was awesome. The other campers were perfect. And now on to Camp Getaway. They really went above and beyond with decorating the whole camp. Everything was covered in John Waters themed things. Pink flamingos were everywhere. From the moment you pulled onto the campus until you got to your room, your eyeballs were assaulted with pink flamingos. They also had movie posters and stills from the film everywhere. Everywhere you turn, there was Divine and Mink Stole and John Waters and all of the filthy characters that we all love. The schedule for the entire event was really extensive. I did not attend every event. I didn't do any sporting events. I really just went to the social gatherings and hung out. For people that wanted to participate in like zip lining or archery or dodgeball or Zumba, those things were happening all day long, every day. One thing that really struck me is that this was a huge group of people that were really creative. Maybe most of us were a little socially awkward. People really got out of their comfort zone. I saw people go to sports classes like the archery and tennis that would have never otherwise attended. I talked to a ton of people that did the zip line that would never have done that. I think being in such a supportive and joyful environment gave people the confidence to try new things. I'm a fan. I like it. So anyway, I'm a little disjointed because a lot happened. It's a lot of information to share. So Friday, I went to the cocktail party meet and greet, and then we all had a sit-down dinner, and they printed out this really cool menu. I got mine signed later in by John Waters at the meet and greet with him. But anyway, here's the menu. And a pink flamingo. Cool, right? So we all ate dinner. Then John Waters came out and said hello and welcomed us to the camp and read from his book, Carsick. He thought that a scary story was appropriate for our bedtime story. And so he read an essay in here that is his imagination, the worst things he could come up with for a ride as a hitchhiker. So it was really fun and spooky, and he is a very good public speaker. After dinner, and the food was okay. I wanna say that the food was great. Like, they've obviously dealt with large crowds of drunk adults before, because it was a lot of carbs and cheese, random fruit, a few healthy things at every meal, but mostly heavy kind of carby food. They were prepared. They have done this before. After we all had dinner and listened to John Waters give his talk, they held a dance party down at the boathouse next to the lake. It was so much fun. They did a lot of group dancing where they got everybody dancing together to a lot of pop songs. Our host for the weekend was named Bluto, and he was hilarious. He introduced himself at the dinner and introduced John Waters. Then he emceed the event at the boathouse. Oh, I almost forgot. Mink Stole was there. She attended the dinner as well. And later in the evening, pretty late actually, at like 1 a.m., karaoke, which was amazing. I only caught a couple of songs because I was exhausted by that time. But people were doing like Mac the Knife Burlesque. She sang a couple of songs. It was a really fun group event. So anyway, I went to the dance party. I participated in all the dorky dancing. There are quite a few videos over on Instagram. If you look at the hashtag Camp John Waters, you'll see some. I'm gonna keep this video about me and my experience. I didn't ask people if I could post their video on here, so I wouldn't feel super comfortable with that. That being said, there are some videos on my Instagram that people did give me permission to post. And there are some videos that other people have posted that are public. So go check it out, because the costumes were amazing. All through the weekend, some people had really planned out their costumes in a detailed way. They had an outfit for every event. So I was exhausted from traveling all night the night before and driving all day. So I went to bed around 1:30 or 2 o'clock. I did have some roommates, which I did not meet until the following morning. I woke up around 8:30, met my roommates, who were really nice. The first thing they commented on was my California vocal fry. I think it's pretty mild. called, but I have heard that it's fairly distinct before. What do you think? How bad is my vocal fry? Let me know in the comments. So Saturday morning, I got up, I got coffee, and then I went right to Bloody Mary Bingo, which was again held right next to the lake. People were out on the lake already playing on all the rafts. They had some beautiful pink flamingo rafts out there. There was a roach raft, which I also thought was very clever. A couple of people did get on the jet skis. I did not get in the water. I thought it would be chillier than it was because I'm thinking like Connecticut, the fall. The weather ended up being beautiful though. It was absolutely perfect. It was about 85 during the day, and at night it was like 65. It was amazing. Light jacket and t-shirt weather. So I went down to Bloody Mary Bingo and I got plastered. There is a video of that on my Instagram. Not of me plastered, but of the bingo. And I pan across and show you the lake. I then immediately had to go for a nap. I ended up sleeping like 2.5 hours, totally conked out. They also had a drag brunch that I saw a little bit of. Once I finished snoozing, I got up and sort of stumbled out to beach area where they were having a 60s dance and barbecue. I had a delicious veggie burger. Regarding that, they did have some vegetarian items, but I think a vegan might have struggled a little bit. You could ask them though. I think that they would have accommodated that in some way and tried to be more conscious of it. There were vegetarian options at most meals. I got a veggie burger. I hung out on the beach. I went to the dance party. I checked out the arts and crafts section, which was super fun. They did enemy bracelets instead of friendship bracelets. Some people made Christmas ornaments. There were 3 or 4 craft times that I saw. I thought the enemy bracelets were pretty clever. After having a snack at the beach party, it was time for the John Waters meet and greet. According to your room, you were given a different time to come to the main gathering area to meet John Waters. I think they did it like in half hour segments. I was at 6:30. I was super, super excited and nervous, and I had a little speech prepared, but I got up to him and totally fell apart and only gave half of it. He was very gracious. In lines, people were so nervous, especially the people in costume. They wanted him to be impressed by what they were wearing, and it was very sweet. People were asking him to sign everything from Whippet canisters to their butt cheeks. It really ran the whole gamut of things that could be signed. And one cool thing that Camp Getaway did with some of the flamingo decorations that were around the camp is they let campers purchase them for like, it was basically a cost, like 20 bucks or so to get it signed by John Waters, which was really fun. I didn't have a ton of room in my suitcase, but I did consider it. So I asked John Waters to sign a menu from dinner, which I already showed you. And I asked him to sign the book that he gave every camper, which was Make Trouble. Look how cute he is. I bought a couple of other things, a t-shirt, 2 other books at the booth that Camp Getaway had set up, but I didn't want to be overwhelming or ask him to sign 10 million things, and maybe I'll go see him speak again and I can ask for him to sign one more, but I didn't want to be one of those people that went up and asked him to do a whole lot. I thought 2 things was more than reasonable.
What I told him was, hi, my name's Ms. I'm a pornographer and I really appreciate your work and thank you, and thank you for this event.
I had something a little more sophisticated planned out, but you know, what are you gonna do?
Nerves.
He was like, how do pornographers make any money these days? And I said, well, you know, we're working artists. And he said, ugh, with the internet, everything's free. And I was like, yes. And then he said, why don't you come sit down? So I sat down, got the photo, said thank you, and left. It was very, very short interaction and seemed to have a good sense of humor. After the meet and greet, there was a little break and a small cocktail party, and then we all had dinner. After dinner, John Waters came out and he did his Filthy World presentation. He got on stage and talked for over 1.5 hours, really covered the gamut. He talks about everything, drugs, sex, gender identity, Donald Trump, art. My favorite thing that he talked about was the concept of unworking. He was like, all of these white women radicals need to go get jobs and just
fuck it up.
Everyone needs to get employed by the government and then just fuck it up. It's called unworking. That's what we need. And I loved that. He also said his famous line that he loves women who hate men and hates men who hate women. And I loved it. It was so nice to hear him say that. He was filthy and dirty and shocking and everything that you would want in a John Waters presentation. Once that was done, we all headed down to the boathouse for the costume contest, which he also judged. that was amazing. To see everybody get up there in their beautiful John Waters themed costumes was fantastic. He teared up during the costume contest seeing all of these characters in front of him, and I thought that was very sweet. And after the costume contest, we commenced with the Corny Collins dance party. Club Getaway had decorated the entire room with all of these signs from the Hairspray films, and it was amazing. They played some themed music and everybody danced. I have never seen more awkward dancing done with more enthusiasm than this room. Like, it was crazy. Everybody was getting down. Sunday, I slept kind of late. A lot of people had to leave early to catch flights or get back to their day jobs the next day. I stayed pretty late. I woke up and played Bloody Mary Bingo again, got a little schnookered, visited with people, said goodbye to several people, and then slept until the very last minute.
Checkout was at 4, and I was checking out at 4.
I would definitely do that event again. I thought it was so fun. If I go next year, which I hope to, I hope they have an event next year, I will bring some costumes and dress up a little bit more. I feel way more prepared, way more socially confident, and had a great time. Thanks so much for watching. I appreciate your curiosity in this. I am really appreciative and thankful that I got to have this opportunity and make so many friends. Like, every single person I met there was fucking awesome. So that's it. I hope to see you again soon. Thanks for watching, and I'll try to be a little more regular with the videos. Thanks, guys.